So I thought that I would make this video on things you need to know before getting a puppy and things that you need to know in order to be the best dog mom possible. So here it is. Anybody who knows me knows that I am a very big dog lover. My dogs are my babies, and I take them everywhere with me, and I treat them like they're my little kids. This is Radar. He was born November 20th of last year. So he's about 3 months old now, and he's our new little baby. He is a crazy, cracked out puppy, full of energy. Ow, don't, no. He's also a miniature schnauzer, and we got him from a breeder in Portland. He's fully papered, and both of his parents are really good, and we just wanted to try another miniature schnauzer and bring him into our family. And if you make it to the end of this incredibly long video, I have some footage of the puppy being a monster at the end. So, yeah, thanks. The first thing I guess you should start with is getting the puppy. If you're gonna get a puppy, you need to do a lot of research into where you're gonna get this dog from. You wanna make sure that you're not getting it from a puppy mill. And I mean, it's common knowledge to avoid puppy mills, but a lot of people don't know what exactly is considered a puppy mill. Pretty much any puppy you're gonna get from a pet store comes from a mill. Breeders are not gonna sell their dogs to pet stores because when a pet store sells a puppy, it usually comes from a backyard breeder or puppy mill, someone who breeds dogs in bulk. It's quantity versus quality. They're popping out puppies as fast as possible. It's usually not a clean environment. It's not good on the mothers, and they usually don't have a lot of care toward their dogs because they view them as products, not as pets. So you really want to make sure where you're getting the dog from. Pet stores generally get puppies from these people because they're selling them in large quantities. They're selling them to the pet stores for very cheap. And then the pet stores are marking it up several hundred dollars and reselling it to you. The breeder of the pet store puppy generally takes them away from the moms between 5 and 7 weeks. And so they're already sent down to the pet store. They can start breeding the mom again. And then the puppies aren't properly socialized when you get them. Versus if you get a dog from a qualified breeder, they're only having so many litters every year. They're making sure that their dogs are quality versus quantity, and instead of selling it for a low price to a pet store, they're selling it for the full price to you. So you're going to spend several hundred dollars for a dog, but it's going to have good health records, it's going to be fully vaccinated, it's going to have its dew claws removed, and it's going to be properly bred and cared for, and you're not looking at promoting people to be backyard breeders or factory farm puppies. The trick in finding a good breeder is asking the questions, when do you let your puppies go? Generally, you do not want to take a puppy home any sooner than 8 weeks. A lot of people who hobby breed or backyard breed will be like, oh, well, he's not nursing anymore. He's already on dry food. He can go now. The mom doesn't want to deal with it anymore. We don't want to deal with the barking. And that is a bunch of crap because if you take a dog away from its mom before its mom has enough time to train it not to bite and how to properly act like a dog, you're gonna be the one who suffers because you're gonna get a little tyrant of a puppy who has so many psychological and behavioral problems that you're gonna wish you hadn't got it. So always push to keep the dog with the mom until at least 8 weeks. It feels like the longest wait ever, trust me, when they say, oh, your puppy's been born, and then you have to count down the days until you get to bring it home. And I know it seems much better to get to bring it home earlier, but the consequences are not worth it. Generally, a good breeder will give you a certificate of health from both parents. They have like a warranty period for how long your puppy's health is guaranteed that the breeder will replace or take back the puppy. They have their first shots when you get them. They encourage you to get the rest of the shots. Obviously, you want to do that. You don't want to invest money into a puppy and then have it get sick. And it's going to cost you a couple hundred dollars, upwards towards $1,000 generally, depending on the breed of dog that you get. And so your initial purchase of a dog, you can estimate will be around $500 to $800, depending on the kind of puppy that you want, if you're going to buy it from a breeder. Unless you want a show dog, show quality, papered, AKC registered, all that stuff, you can be looking around anywhere from $1,000 to $1,500, depending on the breed. So the second most important thing when getting a puppy is, what are you going to feed them? There are so many commercials out there that say, Blue Buffaloes, love them like family, feed them like family. You want to make sure that you're feeding good quality food, because it's common knowledge now that byproduct meal and corn are some things that we should never be feeding our dogs, as well as BHA, glycol, all these sweeteners they're putting in there. And it's just now become a big thing that is talked about a lot, is what we're actually feeding our dogs. Most people just go to Walmart, grab a bag of Beneful, and they don't realize that that stuff is really, really dangerous and causes some serious health side effects later on in their dog's life, because who's going to feed you crap for your dog that's going to hurt it? But nobody was regulating the stuff that we were putting in our dog food, so it was just a bunch of cheap fillers. I'm not going to tell you specifically what you should feed for your dog. I'm just going to say that you want to avoid corn byproduct meal, generally grains in general, no glycol, BHA can cause cancer, artificial additives like that. Byproduct meal is definitely a no. You can just Google that and it'll make you want to throw up, so I don't know why you'd feed that to your dog. But if you're really looking into foods, it shouldn't be that hard. You can go to dogfoodadvisor.com. They're not affiliated with any brands of dog food, so they're going to give you an honest opinion of any food you can buy in the United States or Canada. They're going to rank it 1 to 5 stars versus quality, and they're going to point out the ingredients and which ones are good for your dogs, which ones are not necessary for your dogs, and which ones are beneficial to your dog. So if you just do a little bit of research on that website, just type in a dog food name that you're thinking about feeding, and it'll compare it to all the other dog foods that you could get. Then you can look price point and find something that fits in your budget and your dog's health requirements. By feeding good foods, you're helping to prevent the chances of your dog developing diabetes, allergies, certain types of cancers, and stuff like that. So hopefully your dog will live for a long time, and you won't have to put them down later on down the road because of serious health defects. Also, if you're feeding good dog food, you need to be feeding good treats. And one thing that everybody in the world needs to know is, do not feed your dogs rawhide. I know your dogs like it, but kids like pixie sticks too. And if you're giving your kid pixie sticks every time it wants a snack, then there's something seriously wrong. Rawhide has some serious health consequences. They found that it causes stomach ulcers, tooth decay, gum bleeding, lots of digestive problems, and they're not exactly regulating what they're treating this rawhide with. There's a lot of alternative chews and things you can get for your dog, so I would do a little bit of research into the rawhide thing too. So there's a few things that you should know before you decide that a puppy is a really good idea for you. There's a few truths to getting a puppy. The first thing is, the first couple weeks are going to be terrible. The dog will pee on your floor. You will have to be cleaning up more poop than you could imagine that it could ever produce. You will not get your pet deposit back. I guarantee something will happen and your dog will just destroy something in your house. They're not giving you the pet deposit back. If you bring home a puppy, you just better be aware of that fact. It's going to howl, it's going to whine, and your puppy is not going to behave right off. It's going to be an uphill battle and a struggle. And every 3 seconds, you're going to have to be jumping off the couch and taking something out of its mouth. That much being said, if you still want a puppy, that's great. I guess if you can accept that, then you are ready to have one.
My head is stuck in the clouds. She begs me to come down, says, boy, quit fooling around. I told her I love the view from up here. Warm sun and wind in my ear will watch the world from above as it turns to the rhythm of love. We may only have tonight, but till the morning sun, you're mine, all mine. Play the music low and sway to the rhythm of love.
Anyways, guys, if you're looking into getting another puppy, I hope you like this video, and if you have any other questions, feel free to comment below on this video. And yeah, we'll see you next time. Thanks.
They roll back when she's laughing at me. She rises up like the tide.